Join Charles and Hillary Price for Faith, Hope, and Love, the story of a man who responded to God's call to transform the lives of street children across Kenya.
Wakaribishwa Kenya yetu hakuna matata.
Jambo
bwana, habari gani?
Nzuri sana.
Wageni wakaribishwa.
Welcome to the final part of our special series filmed in Kenya, Faith, Hope and Love. I'm at one of the six homes run by the Mully Children's Family for orphaned, abandoned and abused children. We've witnessed in the past 2 weeks how this organization literally runs on faith, hope and love. Behind me is the Mully Children's Family Choir. They are rehearsing for their upcoming tour of Canada. I, my wife Hillary, and the Living Truth team are here to learn about the MCF plan to build a Christian college and ultimately a university so that students like these will be able to continue their education. The goal is to provide Kenya with future leaders who are grounded in a strong Christian faith and Christian education. Our first story is about a young man named Teddy, who today is here singing with great joy in God. But not so long ago, he was living on the streets with no home. He was a thief and a beggar. We'll see how faith in God, hope for the future, and the love of other people have impacted Teddy's life.
Kenya nchi nzuri.
Hakuna matata.
Welcome to Kenya.
Hakuna matata.
This is the Mully Children's Family Choir. And this is Teddy, a former street boy who loves to sing and perform.
I sing tenor voice, and sometimes I do solos, some of the songs. I do a Giriama song, I do Swahili song. And also in acrobat, I'm at the base of it, so like I carry more than five people or six. And also I do dancing. I also do karate.
Today, Teddy is healthy and strong, well-fed and well-educated. Just over a decade ago, he was desperate and in danger.
Tell me about your family before you went to the streets, Teddy.
I used to live with both my parents, my dad and my mom. Then my father deserted us and married another wife because of the culture, coastal culture, that's polygamy. They are allowed to marry many wives. So we were left under care of a poor mother, and she was illiterate, so she didn't have a secure job to cater for our needs. Sometimes we used to go hungry because we didn't have food. The house that we were living, it was made of mud. Sometimes when rain came, we used to get rained on because there was no roof. It was thatched with grass, and also there was no clothing. My clothes were torn. They were rags.
And what took you out onto the streets?
I did not go to school. I was just left at home, hung around in the streets. So I decided just to go to the streets because there is where I thought, like, I'll find hope.
What did you do on the streets?
In the streets, I used to beg for food. And there, like, no one is there to care for you. You just have, it's survival for the fittest. You have to survive on your own. And the food there wasn't, like, not good to eat. So sometimes I used to get ill because the food that it's thrown, it's dirty, but because you don't have an option, it's the only food that you're going to get.
How old were you at this stage?
I was around 7 years old.
7 years old.
So what I decided is like engage myself in stealing, steal for people, pickpocketing, and stealing other people's property. Then I remember one day I went to a stall and was caught. I was arrested and taken to prison cell. Life in the prison it was not easy because I was around 10 years old by that time. The older people who are much bigger than me, they used to take my food away and I could not say anything because I was youngest. I could not fight. I could not do anything because I feared. I had that fear in me.
When Teddy was released, he went back to the streets. His worst nightmare was waiting for him.
You have one brother and he was murdered. How did that come about and what did that do to you?
I felt so very bad because he was like the only hope that I had. When he was killed, I was filled with much hatred and I desired to avenge my brother's death because the people who murdered him, there was no action taken on them by the government. And I longed that one day, one time, when I come of age, I'm going to avenge my brother's death.
What happened to stop you doing that?
When I joined Mully Children's Family.
Did you meet Charles Mully?
Yes, in the street. One day while we were in the street, he came. He was so different from the other guys like who we used to beg for food. What makes him so concerned about us? Then that's how we met him. I was with my gang by that time. And he prayed for us. The first thing that he did, he gave us food and we ate. Then he asked our stories. We explained and he prayed for us. And then that's, he promised us that he's going to take us to school. We saw hope in him. So we took the chance and then he took us to school.
Teddy is now in his last year of high school. This is how the cycle of poverty will be broken. Teddy works hard, he is bright, and at MCF he has learned to dream dreams.
What career do you want to follow?
I'll really love to do with aviation. I'll like to do airframe and engine. If I do that job, I know the earning that I'll get, I'll be able to help so many other people. I'd like to build a rehabilitation center for them so that I may give them hope as I was given hope by Daddy Mully through God.
Charles Mully has not only given Teddy hope, he has given him faith and love too.
There in MCF Ndalani, it's where now I got saved. My life was changed. I became a new person. Like, there is a verse that says, if anyone is in Christ, he's a new creation. The old has gone, the new has come. That made me to be who I am today, like a good person. Forgive my father who deserted us. Forgive the people who killed my brother. And like, it's the will of God that I'm a changed person through Daddy Mully.
But without help, Teddy will not go to university to achieve his dream of becoming an aviation engineer. MCF does not have the funds to send all the students who qualify academically to public universities. The solution is to build the Mully International University. Stay tuned for more about this exciting project later in the program. But first, Teddy and the Mully Children's Choir rehearse for their Canadian tour.
Watching Faith, Hope, and Love, Living Truth in Kenya.
During his own childhood and early years as an adult, God prepared Charles Mully for his work here at Mully Children's Family. Abandoned at the age of 6, he survived on the streets.
I never saw end of the extreme poverty and hopelessness. So at that state and that situation, is when I felt like I was not worthy of living.
At 16, he was in such deep despair that he wanted to take his own life. But at that critical time, he gave his life to Christ.
And then I surrendered myself and I said, Lord Jesus, come into my heart. And I gave my life to Jesus Christ. From that time, my life completely changed.
He trekked for 3 days to the city of Nairobi to secure his first job at the age of 18. 5 years later, he bought his first car and began a taxi business. It was a true rags-to-riches story. Over the years, this entrepreneur ran many successful businesses and became a multi-millionaire. But then God told him to sell it all and to rescue street children who are living in a desperate situation, just as he had once lived in himself.
When I saw children in the street, when I saw street mothers, everybody, I saw myself.
Despite much opposition, he and his wife Esther were obedient to God, and today the Mully Children's Family is one of the largest rehabilitation organizations in Kenya. It is an astonishing story.
So that's how I became a father to the fatherless, because the Lord God was speaking to me and I felt there was nothing else that I could do. And even when I tried to resist, there was pressure, a lot of pressure in my heart.
Living Truth is here today to tell you about the latest vision of Charles Mully. He plans to build a Christian university alongside the existing vocational college right here at Yatta. You and I have the opportunity to help launch this exciting project. Charles Mully has a proven track record of achieving his vision and goals. We have no doubt that he will succeed in expanding the college to become the Mully International University. Wouldn't it be wonderful for us to look back in years to come and say, yes, we were part of this great work of God.
Charles Mully began the Mully Children's Family in 1989 to save the lives of orphaned, abandoned, and destitute children. Since then, 10,000 children have received care. From the beginning, education has been at the center of its philosophy. The Mully International University is the next visionary step for this Kenyan organization. Put faith, hope, and love into action with your donation. By mail, send to Living Truth, P.O. Box 91100, Bayview Village, Toronto, Ontario, M2K2Y6. By phone, call 1-416-222-3341, extension 289. On the internet, go to livingtruth.ca and use your credit card. All donations are appreciated and acknowledged, no matter how large or how small.
The Mully International University will provide a chance, an opportunity for this needy child who struggled with education from the primary section to the secondary section, and now he has passed to go to the university. He'll have a way to the Mully International University and continue pursuing his or her dreams of life.
You were watching a special edition of Living Truth, shot on location in Kenya.
I just want to
you. Yes, I'm hungry.
Poverty, alcoholism, and the breakdown of the family are the plagues of Kenyan society. When children come to MCF, they receive physical help, food, clothing, safety, and schooling. But they also receive a parent's love and spiritual counseling. Meeting emotional and spiritual needs is even more important for the children's development. The hope is that when these children leave MCF, they will have their own relationship with Jesus Christ. They will be leaders and committed parents who have compassion for those who suffer. This is now the future hope for a young girl called Magdalene.
15-year-old Magdalene came to the Mali children's family 2 years ago, weighed down from a life of poverty. She's only just starting to join in with the rest of the girls her age. Not so long ago, activities like fixing a friend's hair were foreign to her. She's still uncertain, but she's learning to smile, and MCF has become home. Magdalene comes from a village near the MCF home base at Dalani. The beauty of the landscape is a contrast to the poverty of the people. She grew up in this one-room shack. Her parents and three remaining brothers and sisters still live here. Magdalene's father looks after a landowner's cows, but most of the money he earns goes to buy alcohol. The family benefits from MCF's community development projects in the area. Magdalene's mother comes to collect clean water at this pump. Today, Esther Mali visits the family to bring mattresses, clothes, and other gifts.
Papa, he takes a lot of alcohol.
Okay.
So he cannot help his family.
Right.
Yeah. So also he need prayers.
Yes.
So he can believe in Jesus.
Yeah.
And yeah. And maybe later you'll take care of the family.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. Overwork. Overwork. Wana.
Magdalene and her younger sister have come along to visit their family. They both quickly revert to the shy, frightened girls they were when they first came to MCF.
I took them because they couldn't stay here.
Right.
You see, the house is very small, and they are growing now.
Esther is concerned about the sexual danger girls face when they reach puberty.
She said that if we could not come and take the children, they could be just here and suffering just inside the house.
Yeah. The shack is so small, it is difficult to fit the mattresses inside. Even more difficult to imagine is seven people crammed into this space, especially as the rainy season approaches.
It's a small house where they live, and I think we need to pray for them. I know God will do something for them. Yeah. Okay. Thank you.
The roof leaks and the mud brick walls are patched with plastic, but there's no money to fix it.
How do you feel about your children at the Mali home?
She's happy because she can see now their children, they are taking care and they have changed.
How have they changed?
They are clean. They have good health. So she appreciates that.
To the delight of the children, Esther and Hilary give out clothes to Magdalene's younger siblings. There are sheets, blankets, and other supplies for the family too. But Esther knows this family needs more than physical help. They need spiritual help. Hilary prays for the family.
Pray that you would make it possible for them to have a new house.
But Magdalene and her sister are still learning how to pray. Then it's time to go back to MCF. Magdalene's youngest brother comes with them. He receives food, enough for him to carry to the shack and share with the family. Magdalene gets back just in time for football practice. She can be a child again. MCF cannot accommodate all children in poverty. The strategy is to take one or two from a family. Those children are then expected and encouraged to go back and help their families, both spiritually and physically. This is a Kenyan solution to a Kenyan problem.
Lord, and I'm out of mind. I can't look for Lord, and I'm out of mind.
It's hard for us in the West to understand the political and humanitarian crisis that arose in Kenya after the 2007 elections. Historically, there have been so many tribal tensions which fueled the violence. President Kibaki, a member of the Kikuyu tribe, was declared re-elected, and the opposition supporters went on a rampage. They killed many Kikuyu, including 50 women and children, who were locked in a church and burnt alive at Eldoret. Eldoret is where Charles Mully started his first children's home. He tried to rescue as many children as he could from the violence in that area. One of them is called Joyce.
This is what safety looks like. A place to sleep, a full belly. And the wake-up call is from a house mother, not a mob with machetes. The day at the Mali children's family begins with prayers of thanks instead of violence and hunger.
Thank you, Lord, for this day, for mom and dad, in Jesus' name, amen.
Every morning, Joyce comes to the younger children's dormitory to help her sisters get dressed. It is not a chore. She is grateful they have clothes to put on since she and her five siblings came to live at MCF. They are alive and safe.
My name is Mary. I have 7 years old.
My name is Esther. I am 10 years old.
My name is Julius Wong, 4 years.
My name is Joyce Wangoi. I have 14 years.
I'm very much. I am 5 years old.
My name is Florence Anji. I have 6 years old.
Joyce was caught in the post-election violence that rocked Kenya in 2008. She saw her father killed just because he was a member of the Kikuyu tribe. The trauma caused her mother to have a complete mental breakdown. She has never recovered. The children are adjusting to life at MCF, but the pain of their ordeal is never very far below the surface.
Baba ndiye alikufanga. Penye alikufanga, tukabaki na mama. Sasa mama akakuanga mwendo wazi. Sasa penye alikuwa mwendo wazi, tukabaki ni tukio pekeru sasa. Maisha ikakuwa ngumu sasa kila mtu akienda kila kona sasa mimi ndio nikabaki shule nikaachanga nikabaki peke yangu sasa nikaona inaja hata mimi nitoroke acha tu nivumilie nikae na sasa mimi nikakuanga nikaenda nikitafuta kazi ya kufua manguo na wapatie nikipata kama ni 50 bob na wanunulia Kenya tutapata ndio tunakula. Sasa maisha kwa kuanga ngumu. Tukaendelea anga tukikaa tukihustle. Sasa mamangu hatujui kwenye anakuanga sababu alikuwa mwendo wazimu. Hakuna mwenye anatusaidia.
Joyce and the younger children were rounded up by police and put into a Red Cross camp for displaced people. Her older siblings, including Sister Margaret, lived on the streets.
Mimi maisha yangu hata sijui naweza waelezea nini kwa sababu maisha yangu ilikuwa ni mbaya zaidi ilikuwa imefikia kiwango ninataka kujinyonga nilikuwa mimi mwenyewe ninaenda kwa naenda usiku kama tumekosa chakula naenda najiuza saizi sijui maisha yangu ingekuwa ni mbaya zaidi.
MCF was very involved in the relief effort in Eldoret in the years following the election. Margaret was the first to meet Charles Mully, and she was taken out of the chaos to live at the MCF site at Yatta. That left Joyce and her disturbed mother to take care of the younger ones. For 3 years, Joyce endured life at the IDP camp. She became a mother to her younger siblings. Then, Margaret pleaded with Charles Mully to bring Joyce to the safety of MCF. There are now 8 out of the family of 12 children living at MCF. Education is a key component at MCF. Joyce had to leave school when she was 5, so she has got a lot of catching up to do, but she is determined to qualify for university.
So now you're getting an education. What are your hopes for your future?
In future, nikimaliza masomo, nataka kukua judge, ndio nitetee haki za watoto.
Margaret has finished school and works as a house mother with the younger children. In the future, she wants to start her own business.
Maisha yangu vile mnaiona, maisha yangu niko na hope kwa sababu nilikuja MCF, nikaokoka, na tena maisha yangu ikaweza kuchange kulingana na vile mimi niko saizi. Niko na focus, ninasonga mbele na ninajua nitaweza kuweka kazi yangu kubwa, nitaweza kusaidia watu ambao wameza kuwa na maisha ngumu kama yangu.
How have you come to understand the love of God since you've been at MCF?
Mimi venye nimekuja huko Mungu amenitendea sababu alitusaidia tukatoka kwa shida. Akatuleta mahali pazuri. Sasa tunaendelea vizuri. Kwa sababu kama sio Mungu alitusaidia kaonekanie dadia tuchukue, ingekuwa niliolewa kitambo.
So if you hadn't come here, you would have been married off as a young girl, really.
Singasoma.
Mimi ninasikia nikiwa na furaha sana. Ninashukuru Mungu sana kwa sababu ambapo tumefika. Sijui hata nitasema nini. Furaha ambayo niko nayo kwa dadi Muli ambao Mungu amemtumia kusaidia jamii yangu kututoa kwa mbaya tungeweza kujitoa. Mimi sijui hata naweza kumlipa nini. Ni kuambia Mungu tu aendelee kumsaidia na kumpanulia mipaka yake.
This is what safety looks like. The protection of a loving father. Food for sustenance. Education for independence. And friends for companionship. Apart from academic excellence, the core philosophy at the Mully Children's Family is to teach young people how to care for others rather than just looking out for themselves and members of their own tribe.
One of the features of Kenyan society are the tribal tensions. Sometimes they erupt in violence at different times. How are you going to deal with inter-tribal students, which I think is your goal?
In Kenya, we have 42 tribes, and those tribes are represented at MCF, Mully Children Family. And we have learned bringing the old people together, eat together, play together, worship together, learn in school together, and this brings a real love and a working relationship that you cannot have anywhere else. And therefore, that is the concept, the way of life that we'll do with MIU, Mully International University. Bring these young people together. Bring people from Africa, from everywhere, because you build a strong nation, international nation, as well as the Kenyan's nation.
I know the government of Kenya is very concerned about the corruption that is systemic through Kenya and has created so many inequalities. And It is unique for you as a university to have as one of your fundamental philosophies to destroy corruption by this ethical dimension.
The solution is about the philosophy, training people to be free from corruption, be able to, of course, give themselves for others, and whatever they get, then they can also spend to build our nation, our communities, and our families.
In rebuilding this infrastructure of morality, the gospel of Jesus Christ is a central ingredient in your philosophy and in your mission, isn't it?
Yes, it is true. It is based on the solid rock, and that is the Lord Jesus Christ. I know with the Jesus Christ teaching, the Christian values which will be taught to all these students is the way toward success, is the way toward the big light because of the foundation that we have.
Charles Mully believes that young people who are raised without tribal prejudice will bring these positive values to Kenyan society when they are adults. His vision to build a Christian college and university will spread these values to the next generation of leaders and cultural influencers. 30% of the places at the Mully International University will be reserved for MCF students. The rest will be for fee-paying students from across Kenya and the whole of Africa. They too will learn about tolerance, acceptance, and God's love for all people. Today, you have an opportunity to support this visionary project. We hope that many of you will participate financially to make the Mully International University a reality.
What Kenya needs is professionals and leaders who are steeped in Christian values and ethics. Mully International University graduates will be equipped to influence society to help stop the cycle of poverty, family breakdown, and corruption. Today, you have an opportunity to invest in Christian education for Africa's future leaders. Living Truth's goal is to raise $750,000 for classrooms and laboratories. Put faith, hope, and love into action with your donation. By mail, send to Living Truth, P.O. Box 91100, Bayview Village, Toronto, Ontario, M2K2Y6. By phone, call 1-416-222-3341, extension 289. On the internet, go to livingtruth.ca and use your credit card. All donations are appreciated and acknowledged, no matter how large or how small.
It's all about transforming the lives of children and also seeing the children not the way they came in Mully, but they're going out being changed people, transformed people, whereby they'll stand for themselves, they'll do everything that they need because they have that knowledge and skills, and more so, the word of God is in them.
Esther Mully, wife of MCF founder Charles Mully, knows that girls are vulnerable to abuse. So when she got a message about a teenage girl who was being forced into marriage, she arranged to meet her right away.
What is your name?
Felista Smurok-Musai.
16-year-old Felista has heard that MCF is a place where she can be safe and go to school.
My mother is insane. My father died. And I was there with my grandmother. My grandmother was telling me to get married.
Oh, she wanted you to get married?
Yes.
Because
she has no money to educate me.
Teenage girls in Kenya are often married off if they have no parents to care for them. It is surprising that Felista has other goals.
You know me, I'm too young to be married. And decided to to fend for education.
She tells Esther she has two brothers who are also with her grandmother. They are allowed to go to school, but Felista is not.
And what do you want us to do for you?
To help me.
To the world. We will help you. Later we want to go to your home where you come from. Then you can see your relatives or your grandma or then we can know where you come from. Because when you take you, we must tell the government we have you.
Felista is relieved and thankful. They journey on together to investigate another distress call. The next visit concerns an orphaned girl who is too much of a burden for her grandmother. This girl's mother recently died, likely from AIDS. Her body was brought back here from Nairobi to be buried on tribal land.
Now this is the home where we are going. This is a girl which we come to rescue. But I want to ask her a question so I know why she wants us to rescue. Yeah, you wait. Ndiendo ndabye nichakete muenda o the MCF.
The girl's name is Irene. She is 17. She and a younger brother came from Nairobi to live with their grandmother when their mother died. The grandmother does not have enough money to care for them both. The grandmother has found money for school fees for the boy, but not for Irene.
What are you doing for Mdiri? She told me that she was in high school, but she couldn't continue the education because she couldn't pay school fees. Yes, that's why she's staying home. That's why she was asking for help. Yeah.
Esther agrees to take Irene to MCF, and the girl quickly goes to get her few belongings.
She said, thank you very much. May God bless.
There has been so much tragedy and rejection in her 17 years. But Irene is about to find that she has a new family, a permanent one. Both Felista and Irene are on their way to join the Mali children's family. The MCF home at Dalani is already full to overflowing. The new girls will have to sleep two to a bed. But Esther cannot refuse two girls who are denied an education just because they are girls.
God bless you and have a good time with the other girls. See you later. I'll see you maybe tomorrow.
With this warm welcome, the lives of these two girls will have changed forever. They will get an education. They will learn to depend on God. They will become contributing members of Kenyan society. And if they qualify, they may attend university and be leaders in their community. That is why it is so important to build the Mali International University, to give abandoned, rejected, and orphaned children new hope.
I want to introduce you to a wonderful young lady. Her name is Brenda. She's 18 years of age and she grew up in the poverty of the slums of Kibera. Then she came to MCF and every part of her life has been transformed. We want you to meet her and to see the incredible power that MCF has in the lives of its young people.
So selling price is? $2,000. What percentage profit did he make?
Then Brenda recently graduated from the Mali Children's Family High School. She is qualified for university.
I did well and I was the first one in my class, a class of 38 students.
Like all MCF graduates, she will do volunteer work at MCF for a few years until funding can be found to finance further education. Teaching is her way of giving back.
And what do you want to do in the future?
In the future, I'd like to be a mechanical engineer.
Mechanical engineer?
Yeah, because I'm interested in mathematics and physics, so I want to venture in engineering.
Equals to 10 times 2x, 24.
Brenda was amazed to find she had an aptitude for math and physics and that MCF teachers encouraged her interest in science.
According to our tradition, the first priority is they usually gave it to boys because they think girls would just be married. So
when you came here to MCF, were you surprised when you found out girls are just as valuable as boys, treated exactly
yes,
the same?
Yes, I was very much surprised.
Were you?
Yeah. I couldn't imagine that.
What kind of work did you think you might be able to do?
I wanted to be a maid, in short, yeah.
Right, in a big house somewhere.
Yeah.
In Nairobi, yes.
Mm-hmm. Brenda spent the first 14 years of her life here in Kibera, one of the largest slums in Africa. Once a year, she returns to visit her family.
Thank you. But still, you can remember where you used to walk here,
yeah,
or go everywhere?
Yeah, I know this place very well.
Right.
Yeah.
Brenda leads the way through the maze of narrow alleyways. She's taking Daddy Mali, Mummy Esther, plus Charles and Hillary deep into the slum. It is a dangerous place, a grim reminder of her life before MCF. But Brenda is being prepared to return and provide support for her family.
When they come to MCF, they learn to become self-reliant. And being self-reliant means that in their future life, they can support themselves and then support other people. Mm-hmm. Empowered with education, mm-hmm, and then the opportunity of change and transformation. Mm-hmm. That when they change and they become like focused and want to come back to help their people.
Yeah, I'll help them.
Will you?
Just like I've been helped, yeah. Mm-hmm. I'll really work very hard to ensure that they have good life, yeah, in future.
How will you do that?
I'll be successful in life. I'll manage to get a good job, yeah, and I'll just help them. Yeah.
These values are very different to the values she grew up with.
Brenda, you've been here at MCF for 4 years. What was your life like before you came here?
Before I came here, getting food was challenging. My dad could not afford it most of the time because he was a casual. Per day, we could eat supper time.
So you ate about once a day?
Yeah. My dad was very violent to my mom because most of the time he could come back home very angry. I don't know what was wrong with him. And they just start quarreling. Then some of the time he could beat my mom, literally.
And you had 6 siblings?
Yeah.
All living in one?
In one room.
One room?
Yeah.
Did you become a Christian here at MCF?
Yeah, I did become a Christian here in MCF because at home we didn't know much about God. We didn't attend churches. But when I came here, I just changed.
How did this change your life?
I knew that God is everything. Without God, you cannot make it in life. And also, you should not look down upon those who are poor in life. Yeah, because God can make them to be something in life.
Okay, about your mama.
When the group finally arrives at Brenda's house, they find her mother at home.
So thank you. We are happy to be here. And of course, we came to see you. She wanted to see you, really.
Charles and Esther Mali have brought gifts of food as well as encouragement.
Maize flour, jogo, and that we have our daughter as a member of our family. And you are also a member of our family. Yes, and we thank God so much for you. Na amefanya vizuri kwa tabia, na vile vile kwa shule alipita vizuri sana kwenda university. Atakuja kuwa nguzo, atakuja kuwa msaada kubwa katika jamii yako. Kwa hivyo msidi kumuombea na sisi tutazidi kuwaombea. Amen.
Brenda is the oldest of 7 children. When she left at age 14, the family gave up the chance of her bringing in money to help the household. But now they have hope for the future.
Sasa nilikuwa naomba siku moja atoke huko na mazuri. Na kweli nimeona ametoka, alitoka na mazuri. Sasa sijajua what next.
I hope that one day one time I'll come back here and I'll change the situation. I hope that you'll just go to live in an estate and not again in slum. Our life will change forever because I've been relieved, the situation that we were in, I've been relieved by Daddy Muli and Mami Esther, and I'm very grateful for you. Thank you.
If you hadn't come to MCF, where do you think you would be today?
I think I could have involved myself in, I could be a drug addict. Most of my friends, they were drug addicts. I thought that using drugs could make me forget everything that was happening in my background.
Your parents and your family, they are pleased for you, you've told us that. But does it give them new hope for themselves?
Yeah, it has given them new hope. They thought that it is better for them to attend church. They know more about God. And the violence between my mom and my dad has really decreased. It has declined somehow.
That's wonderful that your parents are going to church now. Have they become Christians?
Yeah, they got transformed nowadays. Yeah.
And so it's a different home now.
Yeah, I influenced them to be Christians.
Brenda needs a university education so she can become a mechanical engineer and support her family. The Mali International University is critical for motivated and qualified students like Brenda. There's great excitement among the 18 members of the MCF Mission Choir. They are packing for a month-long tour of Canada. For Teddy and most of the others, it will be a first trip outside of Kenya. There have been months of practice. Singing, acrobatics, and drumming. Today, there are last-minute photos with Daddy Mali, final instructions.
When you go away, know that we are here for you and the children in MCF are praying for you.
And words of encouragement.
And for the honor of our God.
And then they are off on their big journey.
See you, people.
See you soon. See you shortly. Bye-bye.
One of the first stops is the People's Church in Toronto, home of Living Truth.
There are victories to be won. Give me power. Every heart to be true.
All of these teens have come from traumatic backgrounds. One of the most difficult things they have had to learn is how to forgive the people who have wronged them.
That's a must run. There are victories to be won. Give me power. Every heart to be true.
Charles to come and join me.
After the performance, Charles Price interviews Charles Mali.
When you visit Delani, where I've just spent some time with more than 2,000 children, it's not just that they have a roof over their heads and they have food in their stomach and they have the option of education, but they have such a positive, buoyant, ambitious spirit about them. And how do you bring about this spirit of confidence, really?
One is to express the love of Jesus Christ in them and to put it in a practical way. that they can see on a daily basis. And then the other thing is appreciating them, the way they are. When they are dirty, addicted to drugs and the prostitution and the stealing, then you learn to train them and say, I have forgiven you. And therefore, you also need to forgive your either father or somebody who wronged you, who brought you to this world and then left you, abandoned you. Their self-consciousness changes positively through the word of God every day. Prayer, forgiveness, salvation, redemption from the Lord. So that is the key component within MCF, the approach. Love, loving God with all your heart, and again, trusting Him with all your heart and putting all your focus in Him. And then again, what you do on your daily basis, you focus on accomplishing those goals for your future and for God's glory.
Where do you get your vision from? I mean, the whole thing is beyond rational expectation, the way the ministry is developed, the way the family is developed. How do you receive vision and how do you know it's from God?
Number one, trusting in God and having complete and abundant faith. And through the Holy Spirit, through really trusting God, and by faith, and for His own glory, for His own honor, not for Charles Molly, for Him, then I've seen Him doing great things. And therefore, through prayers, and through by faith, God does fulfill the vision. And therefore, now I'm thinking and having that vision of having the Molly International University, where the word of the Lord will be taught with a difference, with a philosophy, having that inspired by the Holy Spirit that will move to change and to transform through the Holy Spirit the young people's mind, the young people's life to become transformers in Africa and in the world.
I hope you've enjoyed these special programs, Faith, Hope, and Love in Africa, over these last 3 weeks. If you've missed any or would like to watch them again, go to livingtruth.ca. You can also stay on the website to donate to the Mali International University Fund, or you can donate by phone or by mail. Next week, we will return to our regular Living Truth program, and now from Hillary, myself, and the Living Truth team, goodbye from Kenya in East Africa. And thank you so much for joining us. May the presence of God encourage you and inspire your heart to continue enjoying and serving Him.
Today, you have an opportunity to invest in Christian education for Africa's future leaders. Living Truth's goal is to raise $750,000 for classrooms and laboratories. Put faith, hope, and love into action with your donation. By mail, send to Living Truth, P.O. Box 91100, Bayview Village, Toronto, Ontario, M2K2Y6. By phone, call 1-416-222-3341, extension 289. On the internet, go to livingtruth.ca and use your credit card. All donations are appreciated and acknowledged, no matter how large or how small.